Hello everybody, it's Gary Pickleface, and today I wanted to rank every single Total Drama contestant from worst to best. Before getting into the ranks, I wanted to say that Total Drama is a reality show that I'm sure everyone has watched at this point, and I'm making this list as it is one of my favorite cartoons of all time. Without further ado, let's get started with my ranking, but before that, I wanted to say this is my opinion, which means it is automatically wrong because you must go with the hive mind of everyone on the internet. Also, I'm basing my rankings off of my own personal bias and also how each character impacted the show, so some entries will be longer than others, but without that, let's get started. So these first few entries are what I consider the bottom of the barrel characters, the ones that I consider the worst of the worst. And with that, let's get on to number 25.
At number 25, we have Blainley. While some of my list might have people dislike my opinion, I think everyone can agree that Blainley is one of the worst characters. For starters, she adds nothing to the main plot except for acting like a total stuck-up to everyone without any charm like Heather had in Ireland. But if you thought she was bad in the main story, the aftermath shows a whole nother level. She was nothing but an asshole to everybody in her path, and only caring about her ego, and unlike other characters who act like this, she has none of the charm they do, and that is why Blainley is at the bottom.
At number 24 and 23, we have both Katie and Sadie. While clearly evident that the best friend thing does not work in a show such as Total Drama, they both are completely obnoxious when they are together, which makes it even worse and can especially be seen at Sadie's elimination with the most obnoxious sounds in the entire series. When one leaves, the other is just useless, and it makes no sense how Sadie even made it that far. And that is why they are at number 24 and 23. At number 22, we have Eva. Nothing much to say here. Eva was a pretty one-dimensional character that contributed nothing of anything, which is why, just like Katie and Sadie, she never returned after Ireland. Even when she was there as a basic uninteresting villain, and her attitude was very unlikable, and unlike other characters, it is not charming in the slightest, and I have no idea why she returned one episode. It was probably but just for filler, but who cares? Those first four characters are definitely the bottom of the barrel, and it only goes uphill from here, with these next set of characters still being on my more unlikable side, but not as hateable as the first four entries. So let's get to number 21. At number 21, we have Ezekiel. Ezekiel is down here because, like the past few characters, he didn't do much of anything. The reason why he is above them in this tier, though, is because of the fact he did not annoy me as much as other characters, but he still kind of annoyed me. But in the end, you have to kind of feel bad for him for turning feral. Him knowing nothing about modern society was the reason why he got kicked off early, but it still does not excuse the fact that him constantly coming back was getting on my nerves after a while. But then again, this is my own personal take, so you might have a different opinion. Who knows? At number 20, we have Sierra. First of all, why was Sierra included besides having the fangirl trope added? In my opinion, it was not very necessary. Second, she should not have made it so far in World Tour as she felt extremely weak compared to Alejandro and Heather. And I guess it was so we can have a more unexpected approach with Cody in the final three, but I think we could have had a better character like we did in Island's final three. Action also had a very weak final two or four, whatever you want to call it. But lastly, her obsession with Cody was very stalker-like and creepy, which always gave me the worst tone going into the show. Overall, she was pretty annoying, but I have to give her some credit for having some winning attributes like her loyalty to Cody throughout the entire show. At number 19, we have Beth. I share the same feelings with her as I did Sierra, except she was a lot less creepy than her. Like earlier, when I said Action's final three was pretty weak, I was specifically talking about Beth, as compared to Duncan, she did not have as much substance. But like Sierra, I feel like her arc really came whenever she stuck up to Heather, starting to the chain of events that people would start to hate Heather more, which is why I really put Beth above the others. At number 18, we have Justin. Out of all the characters, I probably have the least to say about Justin. He was a nobody in Ireland, but in the first half of action, he actually started something that lasted a bit. But the inclusion of Courtney being added back, he just felt like he was in Ireland, a complete nobody. Those next four characters were ones I didn't take much of a liking to, while these next set of characters I find to be mediocre. Not bad, but not good either. At number 17, we have Trent. In Ireland, Trent was a very nice, down-to-earth guy who I quite enjoyed during his time on the show, and his relationship with Gwen was really strong in this season. But then, the inevitable happened, and action came along ruining this. Trent became obsessed with Gwen even when Gwen told him to stop, and the way he would act around her was always weird, and after that, he became extremely unlikable in that sense, in my opinion. Trent went from a nice, caring guy to an overprotective, will do anything for his girlfriend guy, which made him worse, in my opinion. At number 16, we have Bridget. I thought Bridget was a bit lackluster, but still enjoyable in the first season, and her personality was what really made her character and her bond growing into her relationship with Jeff. Was what made me enjoy her. In action, she did absolutely nothing except make annoying sounds, which kind of brought down the mood. Royal Tour sealed it whenever she was just used as another tool for Alejandro, which felt pretty one-dimensional. Overall, Bridget was just a character who started off strong but ended on a weak note. At number 15, we have Izzy. While I am a fan of the Izzy and Chef dynamic, I was never really a fan of her stereotype compared to other contestants of the show. Izzy is just not as entertaining as she is for other people. Even with all that said, I don't think Izzy is terrible. Again, her dynamic with Chef is just sometimes her craziness gets kind of out of hand for me, causing issues such as the plane crashing and always hurting Owen makes her a mediocre character for me. Next up, we have the characters that I consider good. These characters I actually like, and while I don't think they're amazing, they still leave a positive impact for me on the show while watching. At number 14, we have Cody. Cody was a character who I was not really into, but he kind of grew on me. His personality can be very annoying at times, but at other times, he can be a very nice guy, which is why he is up here. He is also in one of my favorite scenes of all time where he punches Duncan, which is probably the most iconic moment he has ever had. Also, this dude sings amazingly, like, what the hell, how? At number 13, we have Tyler. Tyler is a character who I thought was there, but he was always a good comedic relief character who gave me a good chuckle. They were all perfectly timed stunts that were always there to have a more comedic effect to some dull scenes. I also thought his relationship with Lindsay was really good, as it was probably the strongest out of all the ships in the show. At number 12, we have Jeff. Jeff in action was an asshole, I'll admit. The way he would torment his fellow friends was terrible, which is why he is not higher. But him in Ireland was amazing. The way he would never get mad and treat life so chill is what I admired. He came back a little in World Tour, but his glory of Ireland probably will never come. And since I am not including the Redonkulous race, he will be right here. At number 11, we have Owen. Owen is the obvious comic relief character made to give a good laugh out of younger audiences of the show. I still think Owen is a likable, even as I grow older, he can still be likable as a character. Even so, I think the constant fart gags get pretty annoying, and most of the time I cringe. Even so, he can still be enjoyable whenever he interacts with the other cast members in a genuine fashion. Not trying to play anyone and trying to be their friend made him go up here for me. At number 10, we have DJ. DJ is a character who has always been there and has made the show better just by his simple actions. In Ireland in action, he was always a sweet, caring guy, and his relationship with his mama was always a joy to watch. In World Tour, however, his plot with the animals felt empty and utterly useless to me, and it felt like it was put there just for filler. Overall, DJ gradually just got worse and worse as the seasons went on. At number 9, we have Lashana. Lashana Annihilin was one of my favorite characters. Her interactions with the characters in the show were iconic, whether it be her feud with Heather or her friendship with Gwen. She was an extremely good character. Her inaction really took a turn, though, when she started talking crap about everyone behind their back, which really peeved me. In World Tour, she just felt like Bridget, where she was just there as a throwaway character that was there to improve Alejandro, which made me feel sad that her character went extremely downhill. Now we have the characters that I consider best of the best, the top tier. These characters impacted the show in a way I liked. These characters give me a positive impact on the show and are the reason why I come back to watch the show. At number 8 we have Alejandro. Alejandro is the main antagonist of World Tour and he works really well with this. The way he plays brings a new form of tension in the show, and the way he works with Heather and their relationship is the reason why World Tour is my favorite season. His way with tricking the cast into doing what he wants is basically the even worse Heather makes Alejandro a really good and well-written character. At number 7 we have Lindsay. Lindsay is a very charming character with her dumbness making a good comic relief. The scene where Heather betrays her in Ireland is probably the best scene in the entire show, and all her eliminations are just bullshit. In action, she deserved to be in the final 3, as she was one of the characters that carried the show for me, and in World Tour, she was one of the 2 characters I could actually handle in victory. At number 6, we have Gwen. Gwen was my favorite character in Ireland. Words can't describe how much I liked her in Ireland, the way she was just so chill, and at first thought had no chance at winning, but makes it to the final 2, was hype. And her personality and interaction with every character worked, and she was always the perfect balance of good and evil. In action, she was hardly there, so I don't have much of an impression. Then we have World Tour. Good God, she was butchered here. As the love triangle is the stupidest thing to come out of the original 3 seasons, why did they ruin her character so badly? The way she started out with Courtney was so good, and then when she tried to act like the good guy, I was going to lose it. At number 5 we have Duncan. Duncan is probably the most recognizable contestant in Total Drama, and it shows. He has always had the nice balance of harsh yet tame at the same time. In Ireland, although I did not like what he did to Harold, but then his relationship with Courtney was strong. In action, he was probably at his best with him carrying the entire show with the way he played and his carefree attitude always made me like him. However, in World Tour, this all came crashing. No one was not him leaving. It was him coming back and starting the love triangle. After this, he became a complete asshole without any charm from the first 2 seasons. At number 4, we have Heather. Heather is the best antagonist Total Drama has ever seen, and without her, the show would go nowhere. People who say she should have gone out earlier clearly don't understand the impact she has. The way she controlled the entire game and would always trick people to get what she wanted was perfect and could not have been executed better. The punishment she got at the end was deserved and could not have ended her run better for her. In action, she was the butt of everyone's joke, which brings her down a little. In World Tour, however, I would say she competes with Ireland. The way she became the anti-hero and deserved the win after so long ends the perfect 3 seasons. Heather is the perfect antagonist to turn anti-hero, and she deserves to be up here. At number 3, we have Noah. Out of any other character who never made the merge, Noah is definitely the best. Even though he was barely in the first 3 seasons, his personality is what shines. He probably has my favorite personality out of any of the cast. His snarky and sarcastic attitude is perfect, and him and Owen are the best bromance in the entire show. All of his lines are memorable from Island to World Tour, and it's sad that we didn't get to see him more, and he was such a fun character and probably the funniest in the show. At number 2, we have Harold. Harold might be an unpopular choice to some, but for me, he is an extremely memorable character. His dorkiness is likable, and to me, he is the biggest Chad on the planet. Harold in action was amazingly, truly iconic, and it's sad he was hardly in there in World Tour. Also, I'm a bit biased because I wrote an essay about Harold when I was in fifth grade and he got me a free A. On topic, I think Harold is a true, funny, truly amazing character who is close to perfect to me, but there is one character who reigns supreme against all. Now we've almost reached the end of the list. Without further notice, at number one, we have none other than the Total Drama Queen herself, Courtney. Courtney is one of my favorite characters, not just in Total Drama, but in cartoons. Her bossy attitude mixed with her bad side is perfect for me, and she only gets better and better throughout the first three seasons, and since All Stars never existed, she was amazing all the way through. At the start, you can see how she develops from someone who thinks they know best to someone who starts to live life, and all the way through, I enjoyed it. From the first episode where she talks about herself might turn people away, but for me, I think a character like this in a show is perfect, so when people criticize her for it, it always gives me a good laugh. I thought her total drama elimination and island was bullshit, and that's the only thing Harold did wrong, as that's when I feel like she officially became it for me. Her relationship with Duncan started, and it was truly amazing the way she realizes how bad she can be. This is already extremely long, so I want to sum the rest of it up, but I feel the same way in action and in World Tour. I truly felt bad for her. For more details, I'll probably just make a separate video on her, but for now, I will cut it short. Here is the tier list for anybody who asked. Well, that's it. I hope everyone enjoyed this video. This is my first time actually doing something as big as this. But yeah, I hope everyone enjoys. I'm gonna go procrastinate on other videos, but before I wanted to go, I just want to say Total Drama is an amazing show that is filled with nostalgia, and I hope you give it a chance and watch it. And with that, I'll see you guys later, and bye.